Welcome, everyone. Thank you for being here. The topic for today's discussion is Azure Active Directory Identity Protection. My name is Rajat Luthra, and I'm a Senior Program Manager at Microsoft's Identity, Security, and Protection team.
Hello, everyone. My name is Sarah Handler, and I'm also a Program Manager at Microsoft's Identity, Security, and Protection team. Today, we're going to talk about what identity protection is and how it works.
Azure AD Identity Protection is an identity admin's toolbox to prevent, detect, and remediate identity risk in their organization. It monitors every login for identity compromise using numerous detections. These detections can be based on heuristics or machine learning, or they can come from partner products.
Can you share what we do with these detections in identity protection?
Sure. These detections are super valuable. They're the secret Sriracha sauce of identity protection. We use these detections to calculate user risk and sign-in risk. User risk represents the probability an identity is compromised, whereas sign-in risk represents the probability a sign-in is compromised. The sign-in risk can be of real-time or aggregate type. Real-time sign-in risk is based exclusively on detections made during the sign-in, whereas aggregate sign-in risk is based on all detections, including the ones that are issued after the sign-in has taken place. These risks are shown as high, medium, or low in identity protection.
Interesting. Can you share how we use these detections to help our customers?
Sure. These detections are like sunny days in Seattle. They're very valuable. Customers can use these risks to set up automated remediation policies. For example, user risk policy or sign-in risk policy. These risk policies help organizations multiple ways. Number one, they balance security and productivity. For example, all sign-ins are not challenged with an MFA. However, if risk is detected on a sign-in or a user, we will challenge the sign-in based on these policies. Number two, they reduce the time to respond after a compromise. Number three, they reduce help desk cost. Once you set up the policies, no manual intervention is required. And now, finally, number four, they reduce the volume of risk data IT admins have to deal with manually on a daily basis.
That's super cool. We recently made a lot of changes to identity protection. Can you share what's changed?
Sure. So we're always looking for a new acronym. I'm just kidding. We've been doing a lot of improvements. Let's start with the UI. The UI is now much more intuitive and integrated. Number one, we have simplified risk for our overburdened IT admins. They now have only two major types of risk in their direct line of sight, user risk and sign-in risk. Number two, we've integrated with the sign-ins report. So IT admins do not need to correlate detections with sign-ins anymore. Rather than showing IT admins isolated detections, we now show them risky sign-ins. IT admins can click on a sign-in and learn more, including how and why was a sign-in risky. Number three, we now provide deep risk insights and recommendations throughout the feature. And number four, IT admins can immediately protect their users by giving us feedback on our risk assessment. We feed this intel back into our machine learning systems for future detections. And finally, customers can now filter, sort, and perform bulk actions across all reports of identity protection.
So basically, we just have a new UI, right?
Well, UI is just the tip of the iceberg. The enhancements are at every layer. Behind the UI, you'll find some very powerful Microsoft Graph APIs. Customers can use these APIs to get information on risky users, risky sign-ins, or just the underlying detections. Now let's look at our risk assessment engine. We made a lot of improvements there. We've added a new layer of machine learning to come up with an aggregated sign-in risk. With this sign-in risk, IT admins can now prioritize high-risk sign-ins just like they've been prioritizing high-risk users over the others. Talking about high-risk users, we've significantly improved our user risk assessment to consume not just the individual detections, but also other sign-in information. We've improved both precision and recall of our user risk assessment this way. So, to sum up, we reached out to a lot of IT admins and asked them some very tough questions. We asked them about their dreams and learned about their nightmares instead. Their top trending nightmares were risky users and risky sign-ins. These are the entities they were most concerned about. We have aligned the entire identity protection around these entities. IT admins can now have automated policies, detailed reports, powerful APIs, and enhanced machine learning for both risky users and risky sign-ins.
Thanks, Rajat, for that overview of identity protection and the recent changes that we've made. Join us for our next video, where we will discuss how to successfully deploy identity protection.